morning, everybody. My name is Peter Altmaier. I'm the German Minister of the Economy and Energy. I'm perhaps not the most important minister in government, but certainly the biggest by far. And let me extend to all of you on behalf of my government a very warm welcome to Berlin. Ladies and gentlemen, it's an excellent idea by the three organizers to have this summit, because in the very moment where we are discussing and debating our Brexit, where we are discussing a pension reform, a structural policy in Eastern Germany, phasing out of coal, climate protection, all of them are relevant and very important issues, of course, and they eat up most of our attention. Tonight we will have a meeting of the coalition committee in order to solve some of the most controversial issues. But at the same time, when we are discussing all these relevant issues, a revolution is going on. A revolution is going on that is underway already for almost 20 years, but accelerating now in a way that is without the precedent, and it will profoundly change our business and economic environment, not only in Europe, but worldwide. A revolution that is driven not by politicians, not by political guidance, it's driven by technology. It happens because it's possible. Because we have today the possibility to store data, to proceed data, to collect data in a way that was never, never, ever thinkable 40, 30 years ago. And this means that new models are implemented, old ones are changed, and if I may say so, this issue of platform economy is perhaps the biggest economic revolution since the invention of social market economy. Social market economy has changed our world over the last 100 years. It was invented 70 years ago by Ludwig Erhard, a German chancellor. It has triggered the German Wirtschaftswunder. And wherever it was implemented, it worked. Deng Xiaoping, the former Chinese leader, being asked 40 years ago why he, as a communist, could advocate market economy in China. And then the answer was, well, I don't mind whether the cat is black or white. What is important to me is whether it catches mice or not. And market economy is catching mice all the time. Platform economy is the next logical step in order to bring market economy to a higher degree of efficiency. We have seen so many platforms emerge, and what is true, most of the platforms are American or Chinese citizens, not European or German ones. Or, perhaps to be more precise, no longer. No longer. We had intergovernment consultations with the Israeli government, and Chancellor Merkel and Prime Minister Netanyahu organized a workshop with the startups in Israel, working closely together with German companies like Mercedes, BMW, and others. Excellent startups. In Israel, it's exactly the same. They have an environment for startups to grow. But as soon as the startups have grown $1 billion worth, they are taken over by American capital. A country like Israel, with just 10 million people, can make a business model out of that. They have so many startups, and when they are selling them to the US or to China, they can earn a lot of money. A country like Germany, with 82 million people, an industrialized country, will never, ever make a business model out of selling successful startups elsewhere in the world. We have to encourage them to stay, and it means we have to provide the money. I've organized a workshop recently with people from big insurance companies, And it was very honest. I said, well, even if we would be interested in spending more money in this third stage financing, we have not the expertise so far, not the skills to distinguish the startups who deserve money and others where it would be dangerous. We have not acquired the skills to screen the worldwide market of startups and good ideas. So this is something where we are lacking behind. We are not lacking behind in general. We are, as far as classical competitivity is concerned, one of the most innovative and most successful countries worldwide. The World Economic Forum has declared Germany the world's most innovative economy. That's true. After difficult years, in the aftermath of unification, Germany was able to implement structural reforms in the labor market, in social security systems, in our tax system. And today, we have a sound economic growth. We are competitive with countries like China and the US, but at the same time, this revolution that is approaching is something that will change again the starting positions. And it is not just the emergence of platform economies. It is the increasing importance of artificial intelligence applications. And this is so closely linked to the platforms. The platforms, as I have said in the beginning, are a tool to enhance market economy. Yes, competition, yes. But at the same time, these platforms are collecting so many data. They are collecting so many data that can be used for data mining, that they are able to generate new business models. And they have the money to invest in research and development. Google has decided more recently to concentrate on AI research in an unprecedented way. And Google is not the most important investor in AI in the US. There are others and other platforms as well. But in most of the cases, these are platforms. And therefore, the question is, can we afford to ignore any longer the platforms? We can't. We have to think about what we can do to encourage people to create new worldwide operating platforms when it comes to B2B, but also when it comes to B2C. This is a distinction that in my eyes is no longer possible, at least not in such a clear-cut way. And therefore, when I was invited to a panel debate at Freiburg University a couple of weeks ago, I was in a panel with a member of the board of Google, and then in a desperate attempt to motivate my audience, young students from Germany and neighboring countries, I said, well, we are now living in the Internet of Things, and frankly, you from Google, you have the things, you have the web, but we in Germany, we still have the things. And then the Google guy was smiling and replied by saying, yes, that's true, Peter, but maybe we are going one day and buy the things as well. And this is one of the more important challenges. When autonomous driving will be developed, who is going to control the car market? The car manufacturers still, or the manufacturers of the autonomous driving platform? That's an important point. Will you buy your Mercedes and BMW in a Mercedes selling shop, and then you will be asked whether you would like to have it with a Chinese, an American, or a European AI platform? Or are you going to the flagship store of Google in Berlin, and then you are buying the Google digital platform, and then the question is, shall it be combined with a Mercedes then you would have to pay, let's say, 80,000. Should it be combined with the Golf, then perhaps 30,000. And when it comes to a Polo, perhaps the car would be for free. So this is an enormous challenge for all of us. You have now a full day, I imagine, to discuss all these issues. I would be very happy if one of you would then approach my ministry, myself, or somebody else in government, saying, well, we have an ingenious idea. We bring back platforms to Europe. We will create new platforms in the health service, in the B2B area. We need them. We need you. Thank you so much for your attention.
Right. Thank you very much. Thank you, Bill.